one of us. Mike King is in Sutton Coldfield and says the opposition wanted Boris gone, but what if the Conservatives replace him with somebody more competent and empathic? Surely Labour's election victory looks less likely. And then there's the question of Keir Starmer's possible COVID fine on the horizon. He says Labour may have shot themselves in the foot. Let's see, more coming on this, including who comes next after Boris Johnson. We'll also talk about nuclear test veterans, which is a really important story. Emma in Hampshire says, I'm a young army wife. I'm very much in favour of Boris Johnson. This is like Love Island. We don't want people in power who've backstabbed him. They've stopped every department from working by resigning their jobs at a time of crisis for the country. It's unbelievable, says Emma. More coming. BBC Radio 2 smart speaker sounds app, 88 to 91 FM. We'll catch up with the news now.
BBC News at 1 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Boris Johnson has resigned as the leader of the Conservative Party. In a speech outside Downing Street, he said he was immensely proud of all he'd achieved, but it was clearly the will of Conservative MPs that he stand down. And he expressed a wish to stay in post until a replacement's appointed, despite calls for him to leave immediately. In the past half an hour, Boris Johnson has confirmed he's resigning as the leader of the Conservative Party, saying it's clearly the will of his MPs that he stands down. His decision follows an extraordinary 24 hours, which saw the resignation of more than 50 members of his government, including this morning the Northern Ireland Secretary, Brandon Lewis, and the Education Secretary, Michelle Donnellan, who was appointed only 2 days ago. Speaking outside Downing Street to the cheers of his supporters, Mr. Johnson said he would remain as Prime Minister until his successor was appointed, which is expected to be in the autumn.
It is clearly now the will of the Parliamentary Conservative Party that there should be a new leader of that party and therefore a new Prime Minister. And I've agreed with Sir Graham Brady, the chairman of our backbench MPs, that the process of choosing that new leader should begin now. And the timetable will be announced next week.
Mr. Johnson said he was immensely proud of all he'd achieved in office, including delivering Brexit, the COVID vaccine rollout, and the response to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. He considered that some people would be relieved to see him leave, but he had this message for the millions of voters who gave him a majority in the 2019 general election.
Thank you for that incredible mandate, the biggest Conservative majority since 1987, the biggest share of the vote since 1979. And the reason I have fought so hard in the last few days to continue to deliver that mandate in person was not just because I wanted to do so, but because I felt it was my job, my duty, my obligation to you to continue to do what we promised in 2019.
Shortly before making his speech, it emerged that Mr. Johnson had replaced all the cabinet ministers who've resigned in the past few days. Greg Clark's been appointed as the new levelling up secretary after Michael Gove was sacked yesterday. James Cleverly's been made the education secretary, while Robert Buckland is the new secretary of state for Wales. Some Tory MPs have been calling for Mr. Johnson to leave straight away so a caretaker leader and prime minister can be appointed. The former technology minister, Chris Philp, was among those to resign this morning. He says there's a precedent for Mr. Johnson to remain until the outcome of the leadership election.
The main thing we need to do is make sure the government functions on a day-to-day basis. The legislation that's in flight needs to be completed. We need to make sure the basic machinery of government works, get a new leader elected, bring the party and country together and move on. That's what we need to do. But we should also just respectfully keep in mind what Boris has achieved, because he has achieved some impressive things and we shouldn't forget that.
The Labour leader, Sir Keir Starmer, says he would call a vote of confidence in Mr. Johnson if he continued to insist he would remain as Prime Minister until the autumn. But he said what the country really needed was an election.
For me, this isn't a question about who leads the Conservative Party. It's much more fundamental than that. They've been in power for 12 years of empty promises, broken promises, a stagnant economy, wages very, very low, inflation and prices through the roof. We need fundamental change. We need a fresh start for Britain. We need a change of government. We need a Labour government.
In other news, a report by the Office for Budget Responsibility has warned that soaring energy prices risk tipping the UK into a recession. The OBR said the government had already spent as much this year to help households cope as it did supporting the economy through the financial crisis. Police investigating the disappearance of a 20-year-old woman from Bradford have found a body. Detectives have been searching for Samaya Begum for almost 2 weeks. A 52-year-old man has been arrested on suspicion of murder. The Ministry of Defence says at least 248 migrants crossed the Channel to the UK yesterday. They were in five boats. In the city a short time ago, the 100 share index was up 78 points at 7,186. And the weather this afternoon will see plenty of sunshine for most parts of the UK. It'll stay cloudier in the northwest, with a few spells of rain arriving later in the far north. Temperatures reaching highs of 25 Celsius in London, 23 in Cardiff, 21 in Edinburgh and 19 in Belfast. And that's the BBC News coming up to 1:05.
Thank you, Catherine.